time tonight, Pete.
I'm glad, Jeanette.
I always do with you.
I'm glad.
And the stars are just, after all this time, I didn't know you knew all that.
Well, it's not, it's just stuff my dad taught me.
Pete?
Yeah? I love you too. Oh, are you cold?
No.
Want to go inside?
No, I just want to sit. Like this. Close. I feel so close to you tonight, Pete. I like it. It feels safe. I mean, I can think of other ways of being close to you, but that's not what I just like this. This kind of close. You know, right now, I think I'm about as close to you as I can possibly be.
Well, not really. I mean, if you think about it in a different way, you're not really close to me at all. You're actually about as far away from me as you can possibly be. I mean, if you think about it technically, if you're assuming the world is round, like a ball, like a snowball, the farthest away you can be from somebody is if you're sitting right next to them. See, if I'm here, and you're here, then that's far.
Yeah.
But now you're closer.
Yeah.
And closer. And closer. And closer. And closer. And closer.
Potato farm.
I was gonna say, it's flat. There are no trees.
Oh. What?
You're not a lobster, man.
No.
I guess I just thought everyone who was from Maine was a lobster man and talked in that funny way that they do in Maine, but you don't talk that way.
Well, no, you're not down east. You're here up north, and this is how we talk up north, pretty much.
Oh.
Plus, the ocean's a couple hundred miles away. It'd be an awful long ride to work if I were a lobster man.
Yeah. Well, anyway, thanks for letting me stay. I've had enough time to travel lately not to be given any trouble here.
I'm sorry, it's just... I think I love you.
Really?
Yeah, it's just... I saw you from my window and... I love you.
Well, that's very nice, but maybe I should tell you something. That's not what I'm here for.
Oh no, I didn't think that you were.
I'm here to pay my respects to my husband.
Oh.
Husband Wes, he died a few days ago, actually. I came here to see the Northern Lights because, did you know this? The Northern Lights are actually the torches that the recently departed carry on the way to heaven. And you see, it takes his whole 3 days to find his way home to heaven. And you see, I will see them because they are him. This is the third day. It's Friday. And I just came here to say goodbye to my husband and not be bothered, but what you did there just a few seconds ago, that really bothered me. And I think maybe I should just...
Oh, no, I'm sorry if I behaved in a way that I shouldn't have.
I
don't know what happened.
Well, I do. I know what happened.
I'm not the kind of guy who does things like that. Please just don't go. Just stay and do what you need to do, and I won't bother you. Maybe consider what I did a very warm man welcome.
My name's Gordon.
I'm East. It's for Easton. It's the name of the town a little ways away where I was born. It was a mess up on the birth certificate. A son. Easton. Born the 6th of January in the town of Matthew, Maine, instead of the other way around.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Nah.
So, Easton.
Yeah,
I think I passed through there on my way here. Besides, where is here? Where am I? I couldn't find it on my map.
Almost.
What?
You're in unorganized territory. Township 13, Range 7. You're not going to find it on your map because it's not an actual town, technically.
What do you mean?
Well, you see, to be a town, you got to get organized, and we never got around to getting organized. So we're just... almost. What's wrong? Left you.
Yeah, I know.
So then why should you apologize?
Because
why?
Because I killed him! recovery from when they put in my artificial heart, he came and visited me. I was almost better, almost ready to go home, in fact. And then he said he wanted me back. And I told him, Wes, I have a new heart now. It doesn't want you back. And that just killed him.
Oh, but it didn't kill him. You didn't kill
him. Yes, I did. Because he got so sad that my new heart didn't want him back, that he just ran out of the place. And an ambulance that was coming in for an emergency didn't see him and just took him right out.
Boy.
And if I would have been able to take him back, he wouldn't have torn him like that. He wouldn't have brought him down. Please don't do that anymore.
Why not? I love you.
Well, don't.
Why?
Because I won't be able to love you back.
Why not?
Because my real heart's broken. I only got one that pumps blood, and that's all.
Please let me have this.
No, it's mine.
But it's broken.
But it's my heart, East.
It's no good like this.
I
didn't fix it.
Please give that back to me.
Glory.
East, please.
I'm a repairman. I can fix it. It's what I do. Sandrine?
Jimmy.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing good, great. How are you?
Oh, great. How are you?
Great.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah.
You look great.
Oh.
I mean, you do. You look so great.
Thanks.
So pretty.
Thanks, Jimmy.
Well, here, have a seat.
No, really, I can't.
Oh, come on. But I haven't seen you in, well, months.
Yeah.
And months. Yeah, how does that happen, you know? Live in the same town as somebody and you never see him?
I don't know.
I mean, I haven't seen you since, oh, well, you know, the night before the morning when I just woke up and you were gone.
Yeah, look at you two tucked away in a corner over here. Lucky I found you. Is the man and his lovely lady ready for another round? No, we're not together.
Well,
we're all set. Okay.
All set, thanks.
Okay, well, holler if we need anything.
Okay.
No, really, you gotta holler. It's busy up front. Thanks.
So, are you here with anybody, or...?
Yeah, the girls.
Oh.
We're, girls' night. I actually just had to use the ladies' restroom, so I should probably go back to them.
Oh, come on, I haven't seen you. They'll survive without you in another minute or two. What's been going on? Here, have a seat. What you been up to?
Well,
did you hear I took over my dad's business?
Yeah, that's
great. Yeah, running it now.
I heard that.
Running the business.
Heard that.
Running the show.
Congratulations.
Yeah,
good for you.
Yeah, thank you. We still do heating and cooling.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we've expanded too. We do rugs now. Shampoo them.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a lot of work. A lot of work. I mean, I'm on call a lot. I'll do weekends, holidays, because, you know, I let the guys who work for me. Like, you know, East, he does the repairs for me sometimes. I let them have the day off to spend with their families. Because, you know, I don't really have anybody anymore.
Yeah.
when Sister got canned, they left town.
Right.
And my mom and dad, they retired. Headed down south. Yeah, Vermont. Yeah, the winters down there are a lot easier.
Yeah.
Then, Spike. Spike went and died on me.
Ah, Jimmy. I didn't know that.
Yeah. He was old. It was his time now. He was a good fish, though. But anyways, like I was saying, I really don't have anybody anymore. So I was wondering if maybe you wanted to come over. We could catch up, hang out.
And I forgot to tell you, it's a Friday night special here at the Moose Patty. Drinks are free if you're sad. So if you're sad, or if you two little lovebirds are ready for another cup of buds or something, you just let me know, all right? No,
okay.
We're not. Okay.
So what do you say? You want to come over, have a little fun, maybe...
No, Jimmy, I can't. I can't.
Uh-huh, but I...
Yeah, Jimmy. Yeah. There's something I've been meaning to tell you for a while now. Oh, gosh. I've got a guy, Jimmy. There's a guy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, that's good. Getting yourself back out there. Moving on.
Well, actually, Jimmy, it's more than me just moving on and getting myself back out there. This is my, bachelorette party. I'm getting married.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, that's... Thought you said you weren't gonna do that. Get married, I mean. Thought you said it wasn't for you. Guess it just wasn't for you with me. So, who's the lucky guy?
Martin LeFerrier. You know him, the
Ranger guy.
Yeah.
Over in Ashland. He's a legend. Legendary, I mean. If you're lost on a mountain in Maine, he's the one you went out there looking for you.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're lost in this big, bad northern world, Martin LeFerrier is the one you went out there to find you.
Yeah.
And he found you.
Yeah, I'm sorry I never told you, Jimmy. I thought you would have known, I thought you would have heard.
How would I have heard?
Well, you know, people talk.
Not about things that they don't think you want to hear. And, man, I gotta be honest with you, that's not something I would have wanted to hear. So, when's the big event?
Tomorrow.
Really?
Yep.
Well then. Hey! Hey!
What are you doing?
I'm getting our waitress. What was her name again?
I don't know. She's new here.
Hey! Hey!
What are you doing?
You got found. We gotta celebrate. He's quite a guy.
Jimmy.
And so are you.
Jimmy.
Hey! Hey! Hey!
Jimmy, whoa. What's that?
What's what?
That.
Oh. Nothing. A tattoo.
What?
A tattoo. Hey!
Well, when did you get that?
Hey! After you left, sometime.
Well,
hey.
What's it up? What does it say?
Nothing. Nothing, really. It's... Hey! Hey, no, hey!
Villian?
Villain.
Who's Villian?
Villain. It's supposed to say villain.
save Velen? Why would you want it to save Velen?
Cause
why?
Just cause.
Just cause why?
Just cause when a guy has a girl like you, when a guy loses a girl like you, drives a girl like you away, it's criminal. It's just plain criminal. It's villainy. So I marked myself a villain so that girls would know to stay away. So I wouldn't have to go through what I went through with you again. Can I kiss you?
No. You can get that undone, you know?
Yeah.
I got ahead.
Yeah. I'm glad you got found.
Thanks, Jimmy. Hey, sorry. You were bringing me down. I saw you, but it's just so busy up front. There's this bachelorette party, those girls. Good thing it's not drink free if you're glad, because those girls are wicked glad. Gosh, I had to fight my way here to find you, but I did it. I found you. So, what do you need? What can I do for? Another butt? Oh. Pal, well, remember, like I said, drinks are free if you're sad. Just tell me you're sad and you'll drink free. Say the word, let me know, because I know if I'm sad, and you're looking pretty sad. Okay, well, my name's Villian, if you need anything. Just ask for Villian.
Villian?
Yep.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm not sad, but I would like another bud.
All right.
Villian!
Yeah?
I'm glad you found me.
Aw. I'm glad you found me. That's adorable.
That ironing board hurt me. Yeah.
So you should add it to your list.
Should I be afraid of ironing boards?
Well, if someone swings it at your head and wallops you with it, yeah.
Well, it's not. See, I have a list of things to be afraid of, too, and ironing boards are not on it, either.
Oh, it should be, really. No, you shouldn't be afraid of ironing boards.
No?
No.
But they can hurt me.
Yeah.
So, I should be afraid of them.
No.
So, I shouldn't be afraid of them.
Well, if they're used the way you use them, yes.
Oh, I see. So ironing boards are kind of like the opposite of God.
What?
Well, you see, ironing boards, they can hurt me, but I shouldn't be afraid of it. And God, my brother Paul, said that he won't hurt me, but I should fear him.
I guess.
Boy, this is getting really complicated.
What is?
This whole business about what hurts and what doesn't hurt, what to be afraid of and what not to be afraid of.
Are you sure you're okay? You're just going on about crazy stuff.
Oh yeah, I have congenital analgesia, he thinks.
What?
Congenital analgesia.
Who thinks?
My brother Paul. But others call it hereditary sensory neuropathy type 4, but that just basically means I can't feel pain. But you can hit me if you want.
No.
Go ahead. It won't hurt. See?
Ow!
See?
Ow!
See?
Ow!
Come on.
No!
Come on.
No! No!
Alright. You don't have to. Most people don't hit me. Most people just walk away. You can walk away too if you want. My brother Paul said that I shouldn't really talk about myself because I scared him. So I recently put myself on a list of things to be afraid of. But I guess that Paul was...
Oh my God, I'm so sorry.
You hit me. Most people just walk away, but you hit me.
Oh, I have to see.
Yeah, I don't feel pain.
Great. Don't feel pain. Of course you're okay. You should.
Well, is there any blood?
No.
Any discoloration?
No.
Then I'm okay.
Well, buddy, you can be hurt and not look like it.
But?
Trust me, there are things in this world that can hurt you that don't make you bruised and bloody, but there are things in this world that do make you bruised and bloody, and they all hurt.
I'm Steve. I live in the third floor, room 11.
I live with my boyfriend, Eric. I love him very much.
Oh, yeah. We saw you move in.
Yeah, our roof collapsed back in December. No, we're just here so we can get our back on track.
Oh, well, that's good. Because that's what Mom Dudley's boarding house is. A place where people get their feet back on the ground. My brother Paul said we've been trying to get our feet back on the ground our whole lives.
Oh.
Yeah. It takes some people longer to do than others.
Yeah.
You guys are loud.
What?
You and Eric, you yell and bang. We're right below you.
Oh. Sorry, we're going through the rough patch. Sorry. What's it like? Not good.
Well, I don't know. I don't know what it's like to hurt, so I don't know. I don't really feel.
Were you born this way?
Oh, yeah. I don't have fully developed pain sensors. They're immature, my brother Paul said. And because they're immature, he reads. And because they're immature, my development as a human being have been retarded, he says. But he teaches me what hurts, though.
Why?
So I wouldn't ruin myself. See, my body doesn't know what being hurt is, so my mind doesn't know when to be afraid. And my mind doesn't know
doesn't know when to be afraid because my body doesn't know what getting hurt is. So I have to memorize what hurts.
Okay.
And he also teaches me what to be afraid of too. Things like bears, guns, knives, fire, fear. I should fear fear itself. And pretty girls.
Pretty girls?
Yep.
Why should you be afraid of pretty girls?
Because, my brother Paul said, that they can hurt you because they make you love them. And that's something that I should be afraid of too, love. But my brother Paul said that I'm really lucky, but I won't have to deal with love because I have a lot of deficiencies and not very many capacities as a result of the general energy.
What do you mean you never have to deal with love?
Because I wouldn't know what it feels like, Paul says.
Well, why?
Because it hurts.
And it shouldn't?
Plus, I've had a lot of deficiencies and not very many capacities.
Mm-hmm. And what? A lot of people do. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Are you okay?
Well, is there any blood?
No.
Any discoloration?
No.
And I'm all right.
Yeah, you are. I'm sorry I did that to you.
Stop.
You're very sweet.
But you have a boyfriend, and you love him very much.
Yes, I do.
And you just kissed me.
Yes, I did.
And it's Friday night, and you're doing your laundry.
Yes, I am.
And people who are in love with each other, they don't kiss other people and do their laundry on Friday nights. I learned that. People who are in love with each other, they go to the moose patty together, or they go ice skating together, or they go dancing together, and they kiss. You know what? I don't think that's love. Are you and your boyfriend have?
I've been down here longer than I said it, and he doesn't like that.
Who?
My boyfriend.
Who you love very much?
Yes.
Even though you
yeah.
Boy, I have to talk to my brother Paul about this.
Don't talk to your brother Paul about this. Tom, stop teaching you.
But why?
What he's teaching is not something you want to learn.
But I have to know.
No, listen. I was going to be a nurse, so I know. You need to go see a real doctor. You know what? I have to go back home, that I would be back sooner. I really gotta go.
Oh!
I'm so sorry! I'm gonna do that again! Are you okay?
Here you go.
All the love you give me, yeah.
That's a lot. That's a lot.
Yeah.
What am I supposed to do with the model? Can I get it?
Well, I'm sure you'll find a place for it. No, I think it's only fair that you give me mine back because I want it back. All the love I give to you, I want it back. So go get it. Lendl, go get it. Please. Now!
Okay.
What is that?
It's all the love you gave me.
That is not. Is that really all I gave you?
It's all I could find.
Okay. Okay?
Yeah. What's going on?
I told you we're done.
Why do you keep saying that?
Because when I asked you if you ever thought we were going to get married, remember when I asked you that in December? It was snowing.
Yeah.
Well, when I asked you that, you got so quiet, and everybody said that right there should have told me everything.
Okay, everybody who?
Everybody.
But who?
Marvel.
Marvel?
Yes.
Marvel. Yes. She knows everything.
Yes, she said that how quiet you got was all I needed to know, and she's right, you don't love me.
Okay.
Shh. And I've been trying to fix that. I've been trying to make you love me by giving you every bit of love I had, and now I don't have any love left for me, and love's just not good for a person. And so all the love I gave to you, I want it back because I want to bring it with me in case I need it.
Where are you going?
I need to get away from him.
Away from what things? There's nothing in this town to get away from.
Yes, there are. You.
Me?
Yes, you are the things in this town I need to get away from because I need to think and start over, and so all the love I gave to you, I want it back in case I need it. Because I can't very well go around giving your love, because that's all I have right now is the love you gave me, and I can't very well go around giving your love to other guys, because that just doesn't seem right.
The other guys, there are other guys.
No, not yet, but I'm assuming there will be. And so I think that since I know now that you're not ready to do what comes next for people who have been together for quite a long time, I think we're going to be done. So I think it's only fair that we just return the love we gave each other and call it even. Oh, jeez and crow, is this really all I gave you, Wendell? I mean, I thought, I mean, what kind of a person am I if this is all I gave? No, I know I gave you more than this, Wendell, I know it. Did you lose it? Did you lose it, Lendl? Because I know I gave you more than this, and I think you're pulling something on me, and now is not a good time to be pulling something on
me. I'm not pulling anything on you, girl. I wouldn't do that to you. It's just... You know what? I think maybe you should just take what you came for, and we'll just see each other later.
Lendl. Lendl, what is this? What the heck is this, Lendl? This is not... I mean, at least have the decency to give me back, but... Lendl, what is this?
It's a ring, Gail.
What?
It's a ring.
Oh, Lendl, this is a ring. Is this a ring? A ring that you give to someone you've been with for quite a long time if you want to let them know you're ready for... What comes next for people who have been together for quite a long time?
Uh-huh.
Oh. But all the love I gave to you, where is it?
It's right there.
But it...
No, that's
it.
But... No, that's it. That's all the love you gave me. You gave me so much over the years.
I love it.
Yeah. Yeah, and... gave me so much over the years, I didn't know what to do with it all. I put some in the shed and some in the garage. I ended up asking my dad if he had any suggestions, and
All he asked me was, you got it right. I said, done. And then he said, well, if all that stuff comes, there's only about one place to put it, so. He said it would all fit, and he was right. There it is. All the love you gave me, just not in the same form as that you gave it.
Yeah.
You still want it back?
Yes, I do.
Well then. Take it.
Can I keep all that?
Yeah, it's yours.
Well, Wendell, you didn't have to give me a raise. Not what I was asking.
Yes, I did. This time. And it's honorable, so.
Oh, that's very beautiful. Oh, my mom, I'm so sorry. It's just, it was a Friday night. I was sitting home all by myself. We didn't even go out or anything. And I just started thinking, it's just not right. And, I mean, dude.
It still feels like you're mad.
I'm not mad. I just
but
said I wish to be more
are.
Attention, lady. I'm not mad. I was having fun, I thought. I had fun tonight. Did you?
Yeah.
Good.
I mean, Chad pulled me into the mill. I had to work.
I'm not mad about you working, Phil. You gotta work.
I did.
Get it. Phil, where's my shoe?
What?
Where's my shoe? I can't find it.
Well, it's gotta be here.
Where is it? Is this you being funny?
No.
Because it's not funny. It's cold out here.
Well, you're the one that wanted to go skating.
Phil.
We'll find it. It's gotta be here.
I'm not mad. I was never mad. I was disappointed, but now I'm done. I had fun tonight. Skating, I thought it would be fun.
It was.
Then forget all this stuff. No, get us away from the kids and back to where we used to be. We went skating the first time you kissed me on a Friday night, just like this one. Remember? Right here at Echo Pond.
I know where we are. Where the heck is your shoe? Maybe it's in the car. Did you put your skates on out here or in the car?
I put them on right here with you.
Well, it's not.
Oh, a shooting star!
Where? Where?
Shh, shh. I'm wishing. Yeah, you did.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing, it's just not all that surprising.
What?
That you missed it.
What?
The shooting star.
Why?
Because you don't pay attention, Phil.
See, when you say things like that, I feel like you're still mad.
I'm not.
Mars.
I wasn't. Where is my shoe? Maybe it is in the car.
It's not in the car.
I have one shoe on already. I know I didn't put my skates on in the car because I'm wearing the shoe that was out there. And I put my skates on with you, out there, right, Phil? Phil, I put my shoes right next to yours after we put our skates on, but it's not there. This is the weirdest thing. I mean, I'm not going to put one seat on in the car and one out here. What's wrong?
Huh? Oh, I am making a wish of my own. On a regular one. Do you want a wish on with me?
Yeah. Yeah, that'd be nice. Which one?
See Hedgehog Mountain?
Mm-hmm.
Straight up, right above it.
The bright one?
Yeah.
That one?
Yeah.
Right there?
Yeah.
Phil?
Yeah?
That's a planet.
What?
That's a planet, and you're wishing on a planet.
That's right.
Yeah. Well, and it's when you wish upon a star, not when you wish upon a planet.
I know,
or Saturn.
How do you know?
It's set on the weather, Phil. Saturn is going to be the brightest object in the sky this month. It'll be sitting right above Hedgehog Mountain over the next couple of weeks. And your wish is never going to come true if you're wishing on a planet.
Well,
you have got to pay attention.
What are you saying?
What?
That I gotta pay attention.
Because you don't?
What are you talking about?
Happy anniversary. Happy anniversary? That's what I'm talking about.
I knew you were mad.
I'm not mad, Phil.
Pretty soon, out of nowhere, it's gonna get ugly.
Phil, I'm not mad.
I'm sorry. I know I'm missing things, but I gotta take Doug when Chad meets me at the mill. He's helping me, us, out. You know?
I know. I know.
No, you don't know. He's working for us, for the kids. It's lots of times, and it messes me up.
Phil, I'm not mad about you working. You gotta work. I understand that. What I don't understand is why I'm lonely, Phil. I got a husband and a couple of great kids, and I'm lonely. You don't pay attention anymore. You go away, and I don't know where you go, but you go somewhere where you can't pay attention. And you forget things, like your son's first hockey game, or his birthday, or our anniversary. I mean, I brought you here hoping you'd remember about us, but you didn't. And that just makes me so mad. I don't know what to do anymore.
You lie.
What?
You lie so bad.
What?
You're mad at me, but you don't tell me even when I ask
because
you.
Because you wouldn't pay attention,
no,
even if
no,
I
no,
did tell
you. Because you don't know how to tell me how you feel about me. I never know where I am, where I stand. Maybe that's gonna go away. So I know where I am for a second. And you know what? It's only there too, where I go. And you sent me there. And you went a long time before I did. And now, all you do is lie.
I don't lie.
Yes, you do. You said you're not mad, but you're mad. You said you had fun, but you didn't. You didn't have fun tonight, did you?
No.
But you kept saying you did.
I didn't. I didn't have fun tonight, Phil. I don't have fun with you anymore. Did you?
No. I had a rotten all the time.
Well, what are we doing? What are we waiting for?
Just a minute.
I know this isn't going to be easy, but I was out there all alone in this world, and I got scared because all I could think about was how I have no place in this world. But then, just out of nowhere, I realized there is a place in this world that I do have, and that's with you. So I flew, and I took a taxi to get to you because I just had to come see you. I thank God that you're not... Wait, I'm sorry. This is the house. I'm sorry, is Daniel Harding up here? I'm looking for a Daniel Harding.
You're looking for...
Daniel Harding, yeah, he lives here. I thought, but... He doesn't, does he? I am so sorry. Oh my God. Wow. Mm-hmm. I'm really embarrassed.
Who's this woman? What is she doing here?
I thought he'd be here. I always thought he'd be here, always. Do you know him? He's a big guy, big tall guy. Played basketball, always from Maine, center. Really tall. Do you know him? He played hockey too.
Well, don't even answer that, actually.
That's a terrible question to ask somebody in a small town. As everybody in a small town sends everybody else. See, I don't live here anymore, but when I did, I hated it when people would ask me that question. It was worse than when they asked if we had plumbing way over there. Because, you know, people in small towns really don't know each other any better than the people in big towns do. I mean, you know who you know, and you don't know who you don't know, just like anywhere else. So when his parents passed away, he kept this house, I heard. Lived here and stayed here, but I didn't stay at home. I went away.
Most people do.
Yeah. I guess he did too. And I never thought that he would. I guess I lost track. You gotta hold on to people or you lose them. I wish there was something you could keep them in for when you need them, you know? Just like, there he is! He's perfect! And, it's cold up here. Forgot about that.
Yeah.
I can't believe I took a taxi here all the way from Bangor just to see him.
That's 163 miles.
Yep.
Why'd you do that?
I could only fly as close as Bangor, and I needed to get them as fast as I could.
Why?
I need to answer a question that he asked me.
Oh?
Last time I was here, he asked me a very important question, and I didn't answer him. I realize now that it's not a nice thing to do to a person.
That's being a little hard on yourself, don't you think?
He asked me to marry him.
And you?
Didn't answer him, no. But see, that's why I'm here now, is because I'm going to answer him. But, I didn't answer him in the first place because I didn't have an answer then. I mean, I was going to college in the morning, and the night before, I'm about to go off into this world to do what I hope and dream. He has to ask, will you marry me? I mean, come on, what am I supposed to do with that?
I don't know.
I mean, I told him I would be back to the center come up with an answer. You know, I'd think about it overnight, and then I just left him standing right there, actually. I didn't make it back before the center come up with an answer. Or at all. And what if he took that as my answer? I mean, that's not what I was wanting him to think. That wasn't my answer for him. And I think now that, I think he thought I was actually going to say yes.
Well, guys probably aren't going to ask that question unless he thinks it's going to be a yes.
I know that now. And I realized what I'd done to him to Danny, and I realized that, you can't do a thing like not answer the type of question like the one he asked me. You can't do that to a person, especially to someone that you love.
You love him?
Well, I mean, you're a kid, so I don't know if you call it. Yeah, I did, and I do. I dashed all his hopes and dreams.
Come on, you give yourself too much credit. He was young. That's all you need to get your hopes dashed. Be young. And everybody starts out young, so everybody gets their hopes dashed. And besides, you didn't really dash his hopes, because if you dash someone's hopes, that's kind of a nice way of letting down easy, Because it hurts. But it's quick. If you said no, that would have been dashing his hopes. But you did say no. You didn't say anything. You just didn't answer him, and that's going to help a long, slow, painful way. Because it's still there, just hanging on, giving you a little less air to breathe every day until you die.
Yeah. Well, thank you.
What?
I don't know.
Goodbye, Hope.
But you see, I was out there all alone in this world, and I got scared, and then I realized what I'd done to him, to my Danny, and that
you know my name.
Hello.
Danny! Danny, I didn't...
I know.
Danny, I didn't...
I know.
You recognize me? You're just so...
I know.
Small.
Yeah, I lost a lot of hope. Never gonna know more on you.
Oh, Danny, I'm sorry.
Because you know what, Hope? You're early.
And what?
You're early. You said you'd come back with an answer when the sun came up, and Jesus Pro, the sun's not even close to coming up. It just went down a few hours ago. Look how early you are, Hope. That's good of you. So, a taxi all the way from Bangor?
Yeah.
To tell me...
Daniel? Honey? Dan? Who's there?
Does somebody need directions?
It's awful late for directions.
Yeah, she's up. Listen. I'll be in a minute.
Okay.
I hope you find it, Hope. Your place in this world.
Bye. Yes, Danny. Yes.
Trick it! kind of not let it know. And then hopefully, eventually, you start to see what it is. It's a common thing, something that everybody knows. There you go.
This is stupid.
You were doing fine.
Dave.
All right, here. Do what you'd normally do around the house at night and just kind of casually look at it.
I think we just kind of have a couple of us and I talk to you on the phone.
Well, then do that. Where's the kitchen? I'll get you some.
No. I'm all out of buds. I only got 90 light.
All right, then I'll get you a 90 light and you can have
it. No. We got a trick to say, remember? See, I'm tricking it.
It's what people who've known each other for a long amount of time do. So come on. Hey, quit it. How many years have I known you? I come out here every Friday night, and I've never been inside your house for years. That's unnatural. It's unnatural, Rhonda. So let's do what the natural thing is to do, and go inside and have some beers.
No, I don't care what it is. Dave, quit running your stuff. I gotta look at this thing.
You're doing it wrong.
Shh.
You gotta trick it. It's tricky.
Hey. Got something.
Yeah.
Roadkill.
What?
Dead raccoon in the middle of the road.
No, that's not a dead raccoon in the middle.
Deer. Dead bloody deer.
No, Rhonda, that's not a dead deer.
Okay,
no,
moose.
A moose. Rhonda, that's not even something I'd want to paint.
I don't know what it is. Don't get mad at me, Jesus Crow.
You really don't see what it is.
No.
Well, can I give you a hint?
Yeah. What are you doing? Oh, what's that? Why did you do that?
I was giving you a hint.
Well, don't ever do that again, and get out of here!
Hey, Rhonda!
What?
You really are what they say.
What? What did they say?
That you're a little hung up there.
Who says that?
Everybody.
Everybody?
Yeah, they say that you're a little hung up there and that I gotta be a little persistent there.
Who says?
Suzette. And Dan.
Suzette and Dan Harding say that I'm a little hung up there and you have to be persistent there? Well, who else?
Marcy.
Marcy.
And Phil.
Marcy.
Lendl, Gail, Jimmy, and Sandrine.
Sandrine?
And even East. And that's just the name of who.
Well, why would they? I'm good to those guys. I love those guys. Why would they say that about me? Let's talk about me.
No, I don't think they said that about you to be mean. I think they just told me that about you. To warn me when I was getting myself into with you. Because they like you. And me. They're rooting for us, Rhonda.
Well, never told me they were rooting for us.
Well, that's because you're a little hung up there. Sorry. I don't know what I did wrong. I just gave you a kiss. How about maybe giving you one back? It's the polite thing to do. Get a kiss, give a kiss, very fair. So just give me a kiss, Rhonda.
No, I don't know how.
What?
I don't know how. Never done it before. I've went arm wrestling every year since fifth grade in winter carnival. And I work in Bushley's lumber mill. That's not what most guys want, you know, once.
Where are you getting that from?
From everybody.
Well then, I gotta tell you something, Rhonda. You're wrong. Because I know lots of guys that take good long looks at you. So wait. And you've never had...
Nope.
Well, gosh, I think that's kind of neat.
Yeah?
Alright. Do me a favor. You give me a kiss, and I promise I won't say anything bad or anything like that.
No. I'm getting back to this. What is it? Apples? Cherries? Big open face? Rhubarb pie? Hey,
And you're very good at this.
I thought it'd be hard. And it's not. At all. And I feel like I want to do it for a long time.
Well, I know what to do.
Thank you.